Welcome back to our YouTube channel schoolquiz.com. As you know, my name is Danish Agarwal. As we have started our chapter number 1, Matter in Our Surroundings, in which we have covered all the topics of chapter number 1, Matter in Our Surroundings. Now we will discuss our NCERT questions. We will discuss all the major questions of chapter number 1. And in this video, we will discuss three important questions. Like first one is, like liquids generally have low density. As we know, liquid generally have low density as compared to solids, but you can see that ice floats on the surface of water. It's a very curiosity based question. Like you can think that as liquids have low density, but ice floats on the surface of water, why it is so? And second one we will discuss, that is, what is the physical state of water at certain temperatures. So let's start. That is chapter number 1, Matter in Our Surroundings. Matter in our surroundings. So first of all, we will discuss our first important question, that is, liquids generally have low density. First question is, liquids generally have low density as compared to solids. But you have observed that ice floats on the surface of water. Like, as we know that solids have high density as compared to liquids. As like ice is like a solid, why it floats on water? So we will let you know how. Like, what you have done on the surface of water, find out why. So as we know, density will be equal to mass upon volume. So let's start. That is, as we know that ice is expected to be heavier than water. But it is lighter and floats over the water. So basically, is like in ice, so many space is vacant. In case of ice, so many space is vacant. That's why the density is less. As compared to liquids. As the density is less, they will float on the surface of water. So we can write it as, it is lighter and floats on the surface of water. Ice has a cage-like structure, which means that vacant spaces are left when water molecules linked in ice. The number of spaces is comparatively, the number of spaces is comparatively less, the number of spaces is comparatively less than water. The number of spaces is comparatively less in case of water as compared to ice. That number of spaces is comparatively less in case of water as compared to ice. So we can say that ice flows on the surface of the water. Like what is density? Density is mass by volume. As volume is more in case of ice and mass will be less. It means density is less. And in case of water, vacant spaces are less. That's why they have more density as compared to solids. As ice has less density, so it flows on the surface of the water. It's a very, very important question, and it is also curiosity based question. Okay, now we will move to our second question. Second question is, what is the physical state of water at first one is 250 degree Celsius and second one is 100 degree Celsius. So as we know, what is the boiling point of water? Boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius, and freezing point of water is like 0 degree Celsius. As we know, boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius and freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius. So as we see that 250 degree Celsius temperature is there. Temperature is 250 degree Celsius, which is greater than 100 degree Celsius. So above 100 degree Celsius, gas will exist as a vapor phase. It will exist as a vapor phase. And second is 100 degree Celsius. 100 degree Celsius. So as we know, that is boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. It means there is liquid phase. as well as gaseous phase, or we can say that liquid phase as well as vapor phase. Like in case at 250 degree Celsius temperature, only water present in the form of vapors, but in case of 100 degree Celsius, it will present in the form of liquid as well as in the form of gas. So we will note our answer, that is, what is the physical state of water at 100 degree Celsius and 250 degree Celsius? First one is, in case of 250 degree Celsius, so it can be written as, that is boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. Boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius, as above this temperature, water exists in the gaseous state. Water exists in the gaseous state, or in the form of steam. However, at 100 degree Celsius, both liquid and gaseous states are there. Actually, the boiling point temperature actually the boiling point temperature, actually the boiling point temperature both the liquid state, actually at the boiling point temperature both the liquid state as well as gaseous state coexist. Both the liquid as well as gaseous state coexist. So we can say that at 100 degrees Celsius, both liquid and gaseous state will be there. Both liquid and gaseous state will be there. But at case of 250 degrees Celsius temperature, only gaseous phase will be there. Now we will move to third point. Third one is at 25 degrees Celsius. So as already told you that boiling point of water is, that is 100 degrees Celsius, and freezing point of water is, that is 0 degree Celsius. So 25 degrees Celsius, that it lies between 0 to 100. So it will exist as a liquid phase. Fourth one is 0 degree Celsius. So 0 degree Celsius, like freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius. So there is liquid as well as gaseous solid state coexist. As 0 degree Celsius is the freezing point of water. Like there will be liquid phase as well as solid phase is there. Both the phases coexist together. So this is all about our today's questions. That is, first one is why ice flows on the surface of water, and second one is what is the physical state of water at certain temperatures. As I have already told you that ice floats on the surface of water because density is less because its structure is like cage-like structure, and there is lot of vacant space is there. As lot of vacant space is there, mass will be less, volume will be more. That's why density is less as compared to liquids. And we have discussed that is physical states of water at certain temperatures. Like first one was that at 250 degrees Celsius, like it is greater than 100 degrees Celsius, so it will be in the gaseous state. Like 100 degrees Celsius, it is a boiling point of water. So that's why liquid state as well as gaseous state will be there. Third one is 25 degrees Celsius, that it is less than, it lies between boiling point as well as freezing point, so there will be a liquid phase. And fourth one is 0 degrees Celsius, as freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius, so liquid phase as well as gaseous phase will be there. So this is all about for today's video, students. If you have any doubts in any questions, please comment in the comment box section. We will make video on that, and we will remove your query. So thank you, students. Thank you very much.